In almost any fighting game, grabbing exists as an essential part of the rock-paper-scissors formula. Blocking or shielding beats attacks, attacks beat grabs, and grabs beat blocking. This concept is very much a part of Smash, and it has been since the very first Super Smash Bros. On the Nintendo 64. In Smash, grabs lead to a variety of throw options that can result in combos or kills, so landing a grab is often used for way more than just beating shields. In Smash Ultimate, many characters like Mario and Joker will get the biggest reward for finding grabs at early percent, so this will actually be their main goal in the neutral game. In Smash Bros., grabs can also be performed directly from shield, resulting in what's known as a shield grab, which is great for defensive punishes. Smash Ultimate implemented many changes that make grabbing overall nerfed compared to previous Smash titles, and in this video, we'll talk about the risks of grabbing as well as give you some useful tips to help get your hands on that slippery opponent. Have you checked out ProGuides.com? If you're looking for character guides, tier lists, and instant access to coaches, ProGuides.com is the place to be. We've also got exclusive pro courses with top players like MKLeo, Zero, and ESAM, so you can learn Smash from your favorite pros. Before we get into the ways that grabs were nerfed in Ultimate, let's review the types of grabs in general. Standing grabs are the simplest form of grab. They occur whenever a grab is inputted during a character's standing or walking animation. Standing grabs have the best startup frame data of all grab varieties, with some as fast as frame 6. They also have the second lowest cooldown of each grab type. A shield grab is actually a variation of a standing grab. This is because in any Smash game, grab is inputted by a combination of the attack input and the shield input. This is the fastest way to grab from a shielding state because it doesn't require any shield release frames to take place. Shield grabbing is extremely common as an out-of-shield option, letting you grab opponents for misspacing laggy moves on your shield. A dash grab occurs when you input a grab while running or during your initial dash. Dash grabs often have a small lunge that propels the character forward, making it easier to time grabs on distant opponents. On the contrary, dash grabs are slower than standing grabs, coming out on frame 8 for the fastest characters. They also have the longest cooldown of any grab type, making them more committal to whiff. Since they can be performed out of initial dash, dash grabs are excellent whiff punish options out of a dash dance. Lastly, pivot grabs are a special kind of grab that's performed by turning around from dash and grabbing at the same time. Pivot grabs typically offer more range than the other grab varieties. Pivot grabs also have the slowest startup but the lowest cooldown, so they're typically harder to punish. Pivot grabs can also be performed out of a dash, so they're great for punishing landings and approaches by retreating at the last moment. Pivot grabs can also be used to react to roll-ins. Now that we understand the different types of grabs, let's talk about how grabs were changed in Ultimate. First and foremost, the end lag on grabs was universally increased. In Smash 4, Mario's standing grab had 21 frames of lag, whereas in Ultimate, it now has 26. His dash grab received even more lag, and pivot grabs got a few frames tacked on as well. Pivot grabs also have less range, particularly for characters like Bowser, whose pivot grab range was insane in Smash 4. Like Melee Marth levels of insane. This change alone is very significant because the mechanics of Smash Ultimate themselves make grabbing worse in general. In Smash Ultimate, every character is more mobile than in Smash 4 and Brawl thanks to improved dash dancing, so it's less likely that someone will be staying still in shield. Also, the reduction in lag on aerials and other attacks makes it much harder to find a grab as a punish, and you'll be left wide open if you whiff a grab with the increased lag. Basically, they made scissors better and nerfed paper. Another big factor is your spot dodge. Spot dodging in general adds a timing factor to the rock-paper-scissors metaphor because it actually beats both attacks and grabs, and only kinda loses to shields. In Smash Ultimate, spot dodging is pretty broken too, as you can cancel the end lag a few frames early with an attack. When you take a move that beats grabs and can be quickly attacked out of and put it together with a laggy grab, you create a scenario that makes grabbing even riskier. Another huge nerf to grabs is one that specifically affects shield grabs. Although a shield grab is still a standing grab, Ultimate implemented a change that adds 4 frames that a character must shield before shield grabbing out of shield stun. In layman's terms, this means that if you have a frame 6 standing grab and you want a shield grab after someone hits your shield with an attack, that shield grab will actually come out on frame 10, and that's after all of the shield stun is over too. Shield grab was already an option that lost to good horizontal spacing, because no matter how fast it was, a standing grab is limited by its range, so spacing a laggy move far enough away has always been enough to avoid a shield grab. Now we have a game where shield grabbing is slower, and attacks have less lag, so very often, low vertical spacing is enough to be safe against shield grab, even at point-blank range. That's another one for scissors over paper. While Grab's out of shield were nerfed in Ultimate, just about every other out of shield option was buffed. For starters, everyone in Ultimate has only 3 frames of jump squat, which is faster than any character in Smash 4. This makes aerials out of shield a faster and better out of shield option in most cases, and sometimes makes them much faster than a shield grab. Also, up smashes and up specials out of shield no longer need to be jump cancelled. If Ultimate is your first Smash game, then you can disregard this ancient boomer tech. So they can be done instantly out of shield without any jump squat or additional lag frames. Besides shield stun, of course. With so many great out of shield options in this game, why even bother going for a slower, laggier grab? Well, it's certainly true that grabs are much riskier in Ultimate, but the reward from grabbing is still great for characters with throw combos or kill throws. Grabbing is also an essential mix-up for characters that naturally condition opponents into shield, like Fox. Let's take a look at some ways to make finding grabs easier. There are 2 main situations in which you want to grab your opponent. The first is when they're shielding, as shielding fundamentally loses to grab, and the second is when your opponent is in cooldown or landing lag, having whipped an attack or defensive option. The first actually tends to be more tricky. How do you know when your opponent's going to shield? You can certainly react to your opponent's shield animation, and you by all means should, but a lot of times your opponent will do something else by the time you react to their shield. There are specific conditions to look for that increase the likelihood of them holding their shield. The first is the run shield approach. Since running can be cancelled by shielding, this is a common way to approach and occupy space. Pay attention to your opponent's patterns in neutral, and you can start finding grabs as your opponent runs in and shields. Another great way to catch your opponent shielding is by tomahawk grabbing. Also known as an empty jump grab, this tactic threatens your opponent with the potential for an aerial when you jump towards them, tempting them to shield, which you can then quickly punish by fast falling and grabbing. Shielding is also a very common habit after attacking. If your opponent whiffs a move near you, or if they hit your shield with something, there's a good chance they'll put up their shield to defend against your punish. Pay attention and look for habits like this so you can find more grabs. Lastly, punishing neutral getup from ledge with a shield grab is a common high-level strategy. Since the additional startup on shield grabs only happens after your shield is actually hit, you can keep your shield up to stay safe from a getup attack or double jump aerial and still get a fast standing grab if your opponent gets up with no hitbox. Although, the vulnerable cooldown from neutral getup is extremely short, your opponent can't spot dodge until at least frame 2, so you'll have more time to find a grab, especially if your opponent opts to shield after getting up. Players tend to shield after neutral getup in general, so you can look for this as another opportunity to find more grabs. Now comes the other situation to go for grabs, punishing cooldown. If your character doesn't get much reward from grabs and has better whiff punish options, you may opt to just go for those. But since it's very common for players to shield after whiffing, a grab might be the only way to punish certain moves. Finding a dash grab whiff punish from a dash dance is a very common and effective strategy. By strategically using your dash dance, you can bait your opponent to whiff an attack and dash just outside of its range, either pivot grabbing if you're close enough or dashing back in with a dash grab. We mentioned the run shield approach earlier as something to look for to catch your opponent shielding, but this tactic is also something you can use yourself to find grabs. If your opponent is spacing aerials in neutral, you can catch them off guard by running in and shielding at the last moment before they attack. If successful, this will result in the opponent misspacing their attack so you can punish with a shield grab. Just keep in mind that you can't shield during your initial dash, so you'll need to run for a short time first. Although spot dodges are an amazing counter to grabs, they can also be punished by grabs. We mentioned the timing factor that spot dodges add. If your opponent whiffs something or you see them shielding but aren't confident that you have enough time to grab, you can stay close to them and wait and grab to punish a spot dodge or additional whiff. This is also possible from a run shield approach. As one more way to punish cooldown, you can implement parries. Since parrying reduces shield stun and forgoes any shield release frames, a standing grab or dash grab can be performed very quickly, resulting in a much faster and thus better punish compared to a regular shield grab. Grabbing is certainly more risky and difficult to land in Ultimate, but grabbing is and will likely always be an extremely crucial facet of Smash gameplay. If you don't attempt grabs, your opponent can get away with shielding for free and push you back more easily. Even just a few carefully chosen grabs are enough to start conditioning your opponent and keep them on their toes. Thanks for watching, and make sure you go ahead and grab your mouse so you can subscribe to ProGuides and click the bell to keep up with future uploads.